Welcome back to Wayward Wonders with Kirchy Mac and Brian. And hey, look at that. I actually said the intro correctly.
Hey.
We've been continuing to explore up the coast from the last time, and we saw this. We saw what appears to be a water temple, a monument, a guardian temple, whatever they're called.
And yes, I'm not too thrilled about my past experience with Good on the Mindcrack server was not fun times, but this one might not be.
Yeah, may or may not have Elder Guardians and all those things in there, but we'll definitely have to check it out because, oh, all right, well, that answers that question.
Did it? I didn't get an answer.
Oh, I just had the Guardian give me the mining fatigue.
Ah.
Fascinating.
I'm a monster hunter.
So yeah, I've got mining fatigue for 5 minutes, so it will take me hours to punch through sand. But if you're okay, why don't you head over there and go conquer the temple, and I'll sit out here and watch.
Let's see. I still don't got anything.
That's
hear them.
Interesting. I wonder if there's not an actual
spawners.
Elder Guardian in there, and instead it's just interesting. I see the spawners. I will try to keep the guys off of you while you try to break the spawners, since I can't break the spawners, but you can. Oh,
right, let's see.
I have some kind of potion that gives me night vision, which maybe I ought to use because I'm having trouble seeing underwater. Oh my goodness.
Ow.
Ow indeed. There's a creeper up on top who is blinking.
Oh,
do you see this creeper?
Oh, there we go. He got me.
Oh. So now you have mining fatigue as well?
Yeah, and I'm going to start drowning if I don't get up.
Alright. This creeper was, like, blinking a minute ago, I thought.
Blinking? Do they have eyes?
Sorry. It looks, looked like he was gonna explode, but then he didn't explode, but there was no one standing near him. Yeah, it actually kind of gave us a way in, kind of. It'll be harder to get back out. Let's see. I have three potions that have night vision and haste. And so we could use them to see, but without having buckets of milk on us to get rid of the mining fatigue, I think that we will really struggle in this area.
Mm-hmm.
Should we come back at a later point and just mark where it is on the map? Because I do think that this will be very difficult.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, not being able to break blocks in Minecraft is quite the detriment.
I just feel like jumping down there and taking a quick look.
All right, so long as you have blocks to stack back up, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it seems to go down.
I guess, yeah, we could do the maze parts since we have a way in. Can we make... I guess we'd have to pillar out of here or build some ladders out of here. I could actually make some ladders. And ladders... Let me do that really quick. I'm going to craft up some ladders and make a way back out where we don't have to place blocks kind of thing. I don't know if the words that are coming out of my mouth are actually making sense, but... Oh, picking up the crafting table. All right. The crafting table is going to sit there now forever.
Well, I don't actually... I'm not seeing any... It seems like those...
Oh, the guardians aren't spawning?
Guardians were just from those spawners.
I see.
There's none in here.
All right. Well, that could be good. I hear a guardian noise, but yeah, again, that might have been just the one that spawned earlier. All right. Yeah, I feel like... It's just mining fatigue. Whenever I go underwater... Like, I get this white haze that I'm not accustomed to seeing. That makes me feel like there's... Like... Oh. Yeah, you're, like, glowing, like, totally white. Like, I have some kind of weird vision effect in my client right now. That
I'm
not sure
that.
What's causing it. And so I cannot see anything underwater, effectively. I'm going to drink one of these night vision potions. We have all these potions, haven't we?
Yeah. Them.
All right. I have some night vision. Let's see what kind of crazy stuff it does for me.
I think I put those in. I had one. I put it in the ender chest.
Still looks exactly the same underwater. What is going wrong with my... That's so weird. The night vision is like working properly like outdoors. Like I can see all around. The moon is setting. The sun is rising.
Huh. I am going to get lost.
All right, I just got my guardian thingy again. I really don't understand why my vision's going all wonky when I go underwater. Maybe there's some weird graphic setting that I have. I hate to do this on camera, but I'm going to go through my Minecraft options and video settings really quick and see if there's something silly.
Oh. Huh. All right. I'm going to make my way back so I don't get lost in here. But yeah, I'm just kind of walking around without much interference or any interference. Just I hear the guy, but I don't know where he is. He's honking his horn. Oh, see, now I've gone the wrong way.
I see another spawner, actually. I won't be able to break it because I have mining fatigue. But I see another guardian spawner, and it's actually spawning some guardians, so why don't I stay away from that? Are there any others that I can see now that I've got my night vision? Yes, they're all around this temple. Oh, there is an elder. There is actually an elder who's outside under the water over here as well.
Oh, he's outside.
Yes, and I might be able to kill him, except for when I'm above the water, I can see him, and once I go under the water, everything's going to go invisible. But basically, okay, if you look where I am, okay, there's a spawner directly in front of you. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So yeah, if you want to break that, and then there's the elder. He's shooting at you up from your right.
Oh, ow. Oh, yeah, he was.
So if we want to attack him together, even though I can't see very... Oh, yeah, we could use bow and arrow. I forgot all about that.
Is that that's just a normal guy, or is that the main guy?
That's the main guy. Oh, you've never seen the main guy?
I've never seen the main guy. We looked for him.
I see.
Oh, there he is.
He's huge, yeah.
I was shooting
at him. He's a big fish.
A really big fish.
Arrows, I guess, like take on a different trajectory when they go underwater, and so he's kind of hard to hit with arrows underwater. Okay, you're just going after him.
Well, yeah, I'm trying to...
Brave Sir Kurt.
Get him to come back up.
Oh gosh, yeah, when I go underwater, everything just turns completely invisible. What's up with that? I don't know what's wrong with my Minecraft client here.
Oh, here it comes.
All right.
Does he take, like, sword damage?
Yes.
I have... What do I have? I have a splash potion of strength. Oh.
Here he comes. Nice. Oops. Let's juggle him.
Oh. Ow.
All right, I'm taking a little bit of damage here from all the other guardians, unfortunately.
Yeah, he's right over by where the spawner is. Do you want the splash potion of strength?
Sure.
It's like a 6-minute.
Nice. All right. All right, big guy, where you at? You're right here. I can't see you, but if I go straight down, I'll get to you.
Oh, I think I killed him.
Oh.
Yeah, there's a sponge.
Nice. Go, gadget. Ow. Splash potion. All right, if he was the only one, then my mining fatigue will wear off in another minute and 30 seconds, and we could continue to explore this, although we'll probably take a quick break and I'll reset my Minecraft client in case that fixes. Oh no, I see another Elder Guardian. He's way out here.
Oh.
I'm going to go try to attract his attention and get him to the surface. I can see where he is from above with my night vision. I could give you a night vision potion, actually, if you want one, so that you can see him, too.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you got a guy behind you. Oh, yeah. He's attacking me. Good.
All right, I'm going to see if I can get this guy to swim up to the surface, and then when I get back to you, I will try to give you one of these night vision potions, too. All right, where are you at?
Oh, I see him.
All right. Oh, he's shooting at me. There you go. Oh, he's shooting at you.
Yep. Ow. All
right. Well, we got the strength. Oh, gosh. They have thorns when they stick out their little pringly things.
Oh, he's dead.
Hooray. All right. Usually there are three.
Hmm.
And so perhaps... my night vision is worn off. Yeah, this is so weird. Your chainmail is like glowing perfectly white underwater, and the rest of you I can't see.
Yeah, I'm getting normal water.
Yeah, I've never seen this visual artifact.
Oh. Hmm. Come on.
All right. Well, do you want to take a quick break? I'm gonna reset my Minecraft client, and we can both grab some night vision potions and try this again.
Yeah, we'll see if that was the last guy or what. So, sounds good.
We're back. I reset my Minecraft client, and that didn't help. But then Kurt said, are you wearing something that might do it? I have elusive iron leggings, which give me respiration 4. And respiration gives you kind of like underwater vision. And respiration 4 is higher than you normally get in the game. And so it seems like that completely screws up your vision.
Oh, like you're oversaturated. Yeah, adjust your dials.
Exactly. Meanwhile, Kurt has been getting more mining fatigue, so we believe there's another guardian around. We each have another night vision potion that we could drink, and so shall we drink them and then go look around and see if we can find this guy?
We shall drink. Clink.
Bottoms up.
Cheers. All right. Let's see.
And so, looking around, I don't immediately see him. The other guys were swimming around outside, though, which makes me think that he might be outside. I guess the front entrance to this place is kind of down over on this side. Mm-hmm. And so we could also kind of swim in there. I still have ladders, and you can also use torches as like a way to get a temporary breath underwater.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing.
Okay.
Ow.
And so I'm going to see if I can just manage to see this guy somewhere, perhaps inside. Oh, except for it's blocked off. No, you could swim up in here.
Oh, are these? Wait, there's two of them. I think they're spawning.
Oh, no way. Okay.
Yeah, I think there's a spawner here right at the entrance.
Oh, yeah, I see the two of them now. All right, sadly, my respiration. Hello. Crap, has worn off. Yeah, don't hit me with your thingy. You're bad. All right, so where would the spawner be?
I think it's right at the entrance.
Okay.
It's this one. Yeah. Oh, the third one just spawned. I should probably get away from it so they stop spawning.
All right, if we have mining fatigue, we're not going to be able to break the spawner without TNT.
Mm-hmm.
And...
like a TNT minecart that we left in that chest back?
Right, that would work. Or milk buckets is the other possibility.
Ow, okay. I need to get out of the water here.
But
run!
Yes, lacking such things, why don't we back off for now?
Yeah, it just seems... I mean, there might be some sort of prize or something inside.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure there would be.
Once you destroy the spawner, but...
All right.
Otherwise, we're just spinning our wheels.
I agree. All right, so let's go spin our wheels elsewhere. And we will see you, dear viewers, somewhere new.
Yeah, when we gain some traction.
Way to complete the analogy. He claims to be gluten-free, and then I see him pop down this delicious cake and just start munching at it like nobody's business.
It's a gluten-free cake. It's made with... not gluten.
In any case, we're back. We've made it onto the mainland. I guess you're carrying the map again now, and we found another pyramid.
Another pyramid, so...
let's go loot something, it.
Yeah, that we might be able to actually loot without
unless
getting mighty.
Yeah, elder guardians inside here, then we'll probably be okay.
And we're doing it at night, like risky adventures of... great skill.
That's right.
Stuff.
We've been foregoing. Okay, there's a zombie spawner in here. A couple of them. But I don't know if they've really spawned zombies much yet. So I'm going to go ahead and break them. Or you can break that one.
Yep.
All right. I'm going to take a peek in the little side pockets over here. All right, no more spawners over here.
Oh, interesting.
What's interesting, Kurt?
A different... oh. There's ladders.
Ladders.
Mixing things up here.
Indeed, although it looks like the ladder then drops onto like some half slabs or something where you wouldn't be able to jump back up. I do not trust them.
Do you not?
I'm going to carve a staircase down.
Okay. Oh, I'm down here, all right.
Oops. Don't have too much fun without me.
Yep, I'll try not to. Oh, there's like a lot of chests. So many chests.
Oh, I see some of the chests. All right, I'm approaching down there. I hear things other than chests as well. Chests don't make as much noise as the things. That...
yeah, good lord, it's a whole family.
Of baby zombies.
Babies.
Oops. All right.
Oops.
Oh, but the chests are all covered in obsidian.
Yes.
We cannot break the obsidian. We can break the chests. I guess we could break the obsidian if we want to like stand around for a long period of time.
I do. I thought I had a gold pickaxe, but I do not.
A gold pickaxe, huh?
Oh, I'm sorry, a diamond. Well, there's one that had a... yeah, that one.
Right.
A spawner above it. Emeralds?
I think you have emeralds possibly somewhere in your inventory that may be worth stacking up.
Yeah, I have them in my end chest.
Dumping off some things for the moment. And then what do we have over here? A delicious apple, water bottle. All right. If these chests, I guess even if they are trapped, if we have to break them to get in.
Look like they're trapped.
Yeah. I think I'm going to go ahead and punch through one of these chests and we'll just kind of get a sense of what happens. Let me look at my inventory real quick. I'm going to organize my inventory so that all the new stuff appears in the top row. Kablam! And, oh, it was a full set of armor. Terrorist helmet, boots, leggings, and Kevlar, which are leather with protection 1, which honestly is not something that I am in terrific need of right at the moment. I'm going to drop them back off.
This one, name tags, pig spawn, iron horse armor. That's it there.
This one has some more firework rockets that also do not appear to have any fireworks attached to them.
Whoa, that one threw mushrooms across the room.
Some more gold. Oh, another cake.
Is it gluten-free?
It does not have a little tooltip that says gluten-free, so I'm pretty sure this one's for me to eat and not for you. And then... yeah, there's another suit of armor, it looks like. Oh, counter-terrorist helmet. Which appears to be exactly the same as the terrorist helmet, as far as I can tell. Leather and protection 1, I believe.
A very damaged anvil.
I actually have 3 very damaged anvils already stacking in my inventory, so if you want to give me a 4th,
okay.
I will continue to carry those around. And, oh, this one appears to have had a bunch of food, but my inventory has, imagine that, filled up again.
Gold ingot, and that one we've already explored. All right.
All right, so some loot. A little bit of it, it seems to be worth taking.
I'm like, meh. I am unimpressed.
All right, I guess we will move forward once again.
Okay, there is some of that stuff.
Oh, whoa.
What would have triggered it?
Well, if a creeper naturally spawned in here, is that going to be like everywhere down here? Or... oh, there's another one here.
Ah.
Fascinating. Oh man, I just put on these speed boots that we got a little bit ago and I forgot to actually put on. Oh yeah, there's a fair amount of kablamos.
Oh, there's some over here. We could blow up that guardian spawner.
If we could harvest this TNT, it could be prime TNT that once we punch it, it's going to go off. So in case that is the case, I'm making a little staircase up here, and then, yeah, you can kind of, like, jump up the staircase and get away, I think. Yeah, if you're ready to run...
I'm ready to run.
Oh, I see, that'll work as well. I will try punching some of this TNT and see what happens. Nope, it's harvestable. All right, well, now we got TNT.
Hey, woo-hoo! Look at us, finding useful things.
Thank you, Mapmaker. And actually, if there was TNT here, I bet you there's still some more, like, under the ground in here somewhere. Yep, here's some more. Of course, one of these is probably going to be primed now, and we'll be ready for it. Man, these boots are actually, like, super speedy.
Whoa, yeah, you just flew by.
I should have been... yeah, we need to get you some of these boots. Holy crap. We could both just go racing across the desert. I should remember to take them off in combat, because they're gold, so I don't want them to wear out.
Yeah, there's a lot of TNT.
All right, very nice, very nice.
Venus! Harvest the TNT for days.
Yeah, if one of these had gone off, though, yeah, this would have been really bad news for us, I believe.
I wonder what was supposed to trigger that, if anything.
All right.
Indeed. So I guess we'll exit stage up and continue exploring this map that I'm holding, just going this way along the coast, and be back with you when we find something else.
Sounds good. I think I see something else.
Oh, are we back already?
I don't know. I see... this is still the correct direction to go, right?
Yeah.
I see a mound and a... I know I'm going to outrun you over here.
Wolfie blocks?
Yeah, wolfie skeleton area. And right. There's a witch over
Welcome
here
back.
As well. But yeah, I see a bunch of mobs. So I will go free our friend since I can move so quickly. Hey, buddy, come help us. Thank you. And yeah, let's beat up on some skeleton buddies. Ouch!
Okay, that witch just ran into
Gosh,
lava.
I'm moving so fast. I'm okay, I need to back off and regen some health really quick. I'm like overrunning my ability to swing my sword here. I'm actually going to switch out of these boots for a moment. There we go. That's more my speed.
Oh, wow. This guy's got some... Okay, I almost died there.
Yeah, he was hitting pretty hard. Even with the armor. He's taking some fair damage. Where did our wolfie buddy go? I don't see any skeletons running away, so he must have...
He was... He just was loose. Lost dog!
I can't recall. In these areas with these mob goons... Oh, crap. I'm withered and I am losing health.
Uh-oh.
In these areas with the puppies and the skeletons, I know one of them, I guess, is near where we found kind of like a hole into the underground that gave us, you know, just kind of like all the emeralds and different things
underground. Right, right.
But have we found any other kind of loots in these areas?
Not really. I mean, that one was pretty obvious because there was that man-made hole.
Right, a very square hole that just kind of like went down even past the bedrock, like if there was that hole down into the void.
Mm-hmm. So, I don't think we found anything other than we just thought it was a place to get a dog.
Right. All right. And this dog may have gotten away from us. He heard what happened to the last dog, and he was like, nuts to these guys.
Yeah, yeah. Not my kind of folks. Wow, there are a lot of skeletons here, though.
There are.
I suppose maybe because our dog isn't killing them.
Every time I think I've finished off the rest, I see Sabor appear kind of on the horizon. All right, the bow and arrow is really good for this. The witch, on the other hand, I will melee. Take that, mob goon witch. Oh, she poisoned me.
Oh, who could have ever thought such a thing would have happened with a witch?
I have fallen. How could this be? I haven't actually fallen. I'm just poisoned. But I am poisoned for 21 more seconds. So now might be a good time for me to stand around and enjoy the beautiful desert scenery. Pick up some of the experience that my good friend Kurt J. Mack has left for me.
These witches, I swear... I'm going to push this one out into the guardian temple in the ocean here. There we go. Oh, it didn't drop anything worth keeping.
Do you have a power bow at this point? I've lost track.
I have a, punch power 2, infinity and unbreaking.
I see. Okay, so we both have good bows now.
Oh, and I just realized right now my pickaxe gives me extra speed.
Oh. I see what you mean, though, with the punch bow. Yeah, I like... push the switch all the way. Oh, there's another pyramid on the horizon, actually.
Oh.
So perhaps we will have a... It's Brian's cake. Don't try to touch it. a continual run through of multiple enemy areas going on in this episode.
Very specific.
I have such a way with words.
A way word?
There's a skeleton with a diamond sword right above you, so be careful.
Yeah.
Skeletons fighting with swords. Don't they know that arrows are the way?
Fire protection. We're not wearing helmets. Projectile protection 3. Hmm.
Interesting. That's
leather only.
Yeah, I haven't gotten anything too interesting from any of these drops. All right, I think there is one more skeleton up there, but shall we just kind of head on to the pyramid?
Yeah, I think that does it, since we apparently lost the dog as well.
Yeah, I don't know. I didn't see if he just ran off or got killed by the skeletons or ran into a cactus. As
the second dog you've lost.
Yeah. Hadn't thought about that.
Too fine a point on it, but...
2 for 2! At least I'm consistent.
Oh, and we got... Oh, is that another
looks like
pyramid?
A bigger pyramid. That might be a wonder, actually, even. But I guess one thing at a time.
One wonder at a time. Oh, and there's another dog box in the off in the distance. Dog box.
Dog box.
Get your dog boxes.
Oh,
get
there's no box. There's no spawners in this one.
Hmm.
Maybe this one is friendly.
Oh, well, there's a ladder.
All right. Looks like the ladder's like on this side. Oops, here. And it looks like it actually goes down to somewhere. This time I'll be braver. Oh, there's like a whole like under pyramid tomb thing going on.
Ah,
down here,
one of these again.
Yep. One of these again. All right, but if we kind of blitz the place, light it up before much spawns. This one has fewer fences in it, and so it's a bit easier to navigate. Ooh, a bunch of spiders spawners up there.
Yeah.
Oh, I do not have food on the bar. That's not smart.
Oh, the chest.
Because I put down the cake. Oh, imagine that. Kirk found a chest. I actually looked directly at it a moment ago, I think, and I did not see it. All I saw was the spawners. Oh, I'm chest blind.
Finished fighting all those spiders.
Did you say spiting?
Spiting all those fighters.
That's right.
And I didn't have my Bane of Arthropod sword out.
Oh, yeah, I don't even know. I'm just, I've been using a sword that's called not a sword. For the past few episodes. But it's one of my best weapons. Get not assorted, skeletons. Alright, so okay, did you look in that chest?
I did not look in the chest yet. I was...
Alright.
The area was cleared.
I'm going to steal your thunder.
Steal it!
Ooh, Maria's chestplate. Protection 2, fire protection 2, and breaking 3 is gold. A golden chestplate. And a lava bucket. Ooh, there's a very nice potion here. It is called the Great Potion. And it has instant health, strength, speed, haste, resistance, regen, and jump boost. That seems pretty nice. I will make some room in the inventory for that, I do believe. Unless, do you have any good potions on you? Do you want to take that one?
I have a bunch. I have regen, I have healing, I have assassin.
All right, then I'll take it. You don't have to ask me twice.
Speed and jump boost, is that anything anybody wants? Golden apple.
Oh, light feet. I think I actually have some of those. Maybe they're in my under chest. I might be able to stack those later, so I'll grab those.
Okay. Indeed.
Is there a second level to this one? Or I hear like a zombie, but he might be like back up or underneath that little mound. I didn't see a kind of ladder down is the words I'm trying to come out.
Hmm.
But let me look around once more.
Oh, I think it... I found a place, but I think it might just be a normal cave that this place was built upon. Yeah.
All right. Well, then I guess let's go check the much larger pyramid that we saw back outside.
Let us do such things as these. Post haste.
Where did we come in?
From above.
Thank you, Kurt. Oh, I found it. It's over
central
here.
Pillar. Yep. Yeah.
Okay. Ooh, and it's gonna be dark and spooky outside.
Awesome. Ambience. I think is what that's called.
Okay. Yes, I see the other wolfie box that you mentioned.
Ooh, watch that step.
And I see a great pyramid.
And some zombies.
And a little thing with the water in the desert.
A thing. Oasis? Oh, those
what
little
do they call those
things?
Well, is the word that I was trying to come up with. Yes. All right, so there's, it seems like a pretty big pyramid here. But I guess it's not like the Great Pyramid of Giza or anything.
Well, there's another pyramid.
Oh, there's another pyramid.
Are these the two that lead up to the Great
Pyramid?
Maybe,
and then there's like some kind of like tomb-y kind of things over here. Well, I guess the pyramids themselves maybe tomb-y kind of things. Yeah, there's a lot of them. Okay, I think we're definitely coming upon an area. Are you holding the map?
I am holding the map, and okay. I've been forgetting to fill it in, but yeah, we're back. Yeah.
Make sure that it kind of like starts filling in some of this interesting stuff. I seem to recall a famous man once said that when you see graves, you should dig them up.
No, man.
Oh, aha! Man. I found a chest! Ow. I did it. I found a chest, all on my own. It's completely my own idea.
Oh, it's empty.
Ah, this one just has bones and zombie flesh in it.
Most of these, they're empty. They've been... These tombs are dry.
This one's also empty.
Spawn zombie.
I guess, yeah, like a lot of the times that... I guess like archaeologists or whatever like explored these ruins and they found tombs that had already been raided or whatever.
Mm.
So perhaps this is historically accurate. That's what I'm trying to say.
Ah. Getting surrounded by the dead. Oh, wait, look over here.
What? Oh, the Sphinx.
The Great Sphinx. So I assume we are, obviously.
At a wonder.
We have not been prompted about it yet, unless...
I imagine the Sphinx might be the main attraction.
Look to your left, however.
Oh. Oh, even bigger pyramid.
Yes, I think that there is the Great Pyramid. And great googly moogly, we might have to, actually we will have to, this is a big place, explore this in the next episode of Wayward Wonders.
Alright, I found a spawn egg inside this one, but it's a spawn skeleton egg, and so that's not particularly exciting. Next episode of Wayward Wonders, the Great Pyramids of Giza and the Sphinx and all kinds of good stuff coming up.
Walk like an Egyptian.
see you guys next time.
See ya.